Hi guys, my name is Harvansh and thanks for watching my other video about the SCCM tutorial. So today's video is about how we can install our SCCM client. So here we'll learn with the different scenario. I have created a lab especially for to learn and analyze how we can install the SCCM client. So here we'll see something deep dive about the logs and the client installation progress. So let me show you something. Before installing the client, we need some prerequisite. And before that also we'll come to know what is the SCCM client. So SCCM client is a a tool where it will install to the end user machine and it will communicate to SCCM console. To control this machine, end user machine, SCCM need any tool available on that remote machine. So SCCM can push virus definition, SCCM can push package, patches and the other things. So on the end user machine, client will receive that package and based on the policy and the setting or what time we want, so it will trigger that installation. So that's why we are using SCCM client. So SCCM client basically to manage the our end user machine. So it's a small tool and it will communicate with the sync up with the SCCM console. So now the question is how we can install that SCCM client on the end user machine and what would be the prerequisite. Okay, so I have just make a roughly something to make it remember. So I don't want to miss out during this video anything which I can't tell you. So here is a SCCM prerequisite. So in SCCM client installation, what kind of prerequisite it required? First thing is client push account should be configured. Okay, so in my SCCM console, let's see where is the SCCM client push account. So this is now my site code and here is SCCM client installation setting. Okay, so just click here and click on SCCM client push and here is an option. This option is enable automatically site-wide client push installation. So as it mentioned automatic. If I select this and after the discovery, whichever machine will discover in my SCCM, this client push, what it will do automatically, it will push the client to end user machine. So basically what happened when your system discovery is running, any machine discover and came to your SCCM and later on this client push, this feature will do a client installation on end user machine. So I have disabled it. I want to push it the manually. Okay, even you can do the automatic also by selecting this. Here is a the system type, workstation, and if you select this option, so these will be the highlighted. Okay, so here is another option, always install the on the domain controller. So if you are having DC, in the DC if you want to install, you can select it. Why this is mentioned categorized? Because DC is the most critical part in our infrastructure. That's why Microsoft has given the two options. Here is the account. Okay, so already I have configured, but I can show you how to configure. You can remove this and here you click existing account, you can set up, and if you want to new account, so you can give search in, I can use my SQL. I have a account by name the SQL. You can give here if the password you are giving, so you can configure like that. Here you have to check the connectivity. Okay, so specify the share path. Okay, so it will test based on your share path. You give the any share path that it will try to connect it for the test connection. So that's how you can edit your account here. Okay, if okay, fine, that is enough. Now it is a site property. Why this is site property is required? Because when you selected the this option is automatically, so when automatically client will push, So it required a site code where it will report. Okay, why? So is it a compulsory to give the site code? No, actually not when you are having a single one site. So if you are having a only the one site, then it's not required. But if you are having a multiple sites, like 2-3 sites, and you want my this client should be reported to particular this client only, this site only, in that scenario you can configure here. Okay, so that's why we are using the site code here. Now let's see the another prerequisite. So client push account, this is done, we verified. Okay, now next is the network access account. What I was showing, this called as a network access account. So this network access account should have administrator privileges on your end user machine. So what does that mean? Network access account should added as a network administrator. So want to say like, this is the my end user machine, and here if I go to the computer management, and in the groups, and here is the administrator. So this is my SCCM account. Okay, so it should have proper rights, means it should be part of the administrator group, or else your client installation will fail. Okay, so now is the next thing is machine able to resolve the MPFQDN name. So when you are in the domain CMT, or let me ping sccm.wunsch.com. So I have the, this is my the MPFQDN name. So if it is pinging, if it is able to resolve, it's more than enough. So this also done, and we can see this also we checked, and now is the port 443.445.135 port 80. So these port also should be open in the firewall. So let's see where we can check and configure our firewall port. So here if I'm going under the firewall, here is a advanced setting, the directional. So here I have allow 445.135.143.343.443 port 80 has not configured. Actually port 80 is used when you are in the work group machine, but let me add it. I will show you how you can allow it. So right click on that and select the custom, click on next, click next, and here I have to select the TCP specific port, and here is a port 80 I define. Next, 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 and the next. Here you can mention anything which easily you can remember it. So now my port it is allowed here. Okay, so now my the port configuration is done. This part also we checked it, and the file and print sharing on firewall and the WMI. Okay, let me check, we are on the firewall only. So here is a file and print, let me search where it is. Okay, so these are the file and printing services, it should be enabled. Okay, so file and printing sharing echo IICMP 4, these are should be enabled. These are enabled for some other reasons, so or maybe the by default, I'm not sure, but this file and print should be enabled. These you can see in it is say grayed out, it's a disabled. Now we'll check the another prerequisite. WMI should be enabled on the firewall. Okay, so let's see the WMI also. So press W, and here is the WMI. This is I am talking about WMI management, HTTP in, HTTP in. Okay, so these WMI, this is the WMI. So WMI should be enabled with the DCOM and the IN, or else your client installation will be failed. So it's a prerequisite. So these also as it done, and these also we checked, it's a done. And the second thing, when we are in the work group, so host file should entry should be added MP and the AD. So that's why firewall is. Okay. So this prerequisite we'll see in the my workgroup machine. Let me see, is it is a workgroup machine? Yes, it is a workgroup machine. And now I can check the host file. We can go direct like it, typing the drivers, and under the etc folder, this is the my host file. So host file should have the entry. This entry is must. Your AD entry should be must, or else it will not get the MP. It unable to search the MP. MP is always published in AD, and when you are installing your SCCM client in the workgroup machine, and it able to resolve, it able to reach the AD, and in the AD it will gather the detail from MP. Okay guys, so these are the prerequisite for client push and the manual installation. Now we'll move it to our scenario part. So scenario, what I choose is three scenarios. When the machine is added to domain and it discover in the console. Okay, so you run the discovery and your machine is discovered and it's showing in a SCCM console. So that will be our the first case scenario. Second test scenario will be when the machine is added to domain, it's a part of a domain but it not discovered. So how we will install? So in the first scenario, we'll use the client push method, and other thing here we'll use manual installation because it not discovered, and here also when something goes wrong. Will use the manual, and here also obviously we have to use the manual only because it's a in a domain oh sorry it's in a workgroup machine. So let's start this thing, and we'll see how we can install the client. Now the first scenario will take it this part. Let me highlight it something, or let me change the color. So it's something like that. Okay, so we'll work on this point, and I am taking in my machine. This is my testing machine for this. This is the host name, we can take it. So host name is SQL2K16, and it should be discovered here as per our scenario. Let me go to devices, and my machine is here. Here I will use my client push installation to install the client. Before that, we can check one more thing. Here on the C drive, here should not be C drive Windows, here should not be any folder. Okay, so here three folder will be creating: CCM setup, CCM cache, and the CCM folder. So let me push the client here, and we'll see the how progress it will work. And let's see, client install here, and I have to select this option. I want to report to my BLR primary. Next, now my client is pushed there. Let me check logs in the console side, how I would be sure whether this is working or not. So let me go to the my logs file. And here is a CCM. Okay, so it's trying to push there. You can see we are a little delay to connect it. It was using it. Bad sort account is not successful, or some small error. Better we'll go to the client machine only, we'll see. Okay, so that error doesn't matter, it was trying to check some other things. So here is folder created, CCM setup, and logs. I am on the test machine, and I'm checking the CCM setup whether it started or not. Okay, so now it is started installation. And we have to wait till this installation will not completed. It will not take much time. It just will be like a few minutes only. Okay, so it's done. Very fastly it post because I am in a like a same subnet, and as you know it's a VM, so it will be the very fast. So here client install, exit code is 0, that means is client installation success. Okay, so now I can check the other thing. Go to the Windows. CCM cache is created. CCM cache is a folder where the all the package will be downloading here. When you are deploying any package, pushing any package to the end user machine, first it will download to the cache folder. So it like a storage folder here for SCCM client. This is a SCCM, this is CCM folder. Here we'll check the logs file. So here is a few logs only, but we'll check the policy agent. So it's saying like a configuring the site code change. Okay, let me go to the control panel and see the my client is there or not. Okay, so my client is came here in control panel, and when newly you install the client, immediately it will not get the policy. You have to run the action tool. Okay, it's I think it's automatically run, and it start configuring. So you can see in the logs file in background. So logs file also increased. And here this was the my the policy agent, and it start getting the policy. So as I explained you in the my last video about the boundary, so this client is part of the boundary. If it is not part of the boundary, it will not get the policy. So this is the thing, and it's getting the other policies as well. Let me close this, and we will reopen and we'll see. Okay, now see the console also got change, and it's showing like a MP assign is a SCCM.once.com, certificate is self assigned, site code is BLR, and the client is this. So that means is my client installed successfully and it's working fine. Now there is no issue. Next step is to verify. Now few logs will be adding here. It will goes to around the 70 or 75 till the few more logs will come. We can see the client location. Yes, it is here. So client location is using for to check the client location, where is my client gone after install the client, where it went. So site code is the BLR, and the MP is taken SCCM.once.com, and the MP HTTPS enabled equal to 0. The current MP is assigned SCCM MP. So rotating assigned the MP, new MP, it installed first MP, it taken like a SCCM-DP, but again it roll back to SCCM MP. So that is a there is an option in SCCM. If you want to give the preferred MP, so it will take on his own and search the preferred MP. So first it will try to reach out the nearest MP, and the nearest MP is this. If this MP is not responding, then client will reach to the default MP. So my default MP on a SCCM server. So that's how we can check the logs file here, and it looks like almost completed. Let me go to the console. So now here I am on the console. Here you can see there was a few errors, but now it gone. So these were the errors, but it doesn't matter if such errors come. And here you can see in it was start installing. Next time this error didn't came, because first attempt maybe error came, and again it tried, it resolved. So submitting the queries. So you can read this logs from where it's trying to attempt, which account it using. So it's using the 180/SCCM account to install that client. And these are the totally logs for that. And there is again few errors. Something got failed.
And but if the client is installed, you can ignore it. It's not a matter. Okay, so now here is, I can go to the console and here was no client. Let me refresh. So yes, here is showing now SCCM client is yes, site code is BLR, client is active, but still it not showing green because it will take some time to configure. Okay, so we cannot wait until it will configure. We can move it to the second scenario. So this scenario is completed. How we can push the client on the remote machine. Now, second scenario is machine added to the domain, but it not discover. Okay, so let's see the scenario. I have a machine here. This is my test machine. And let me check whether it's added to the domain. Domain name is the vansh.com. And let me check this host name. So this is my host name, Windows 7 test. Okay. Here I am back. And here I can see this machine is not discovered in my SCCM. Okay. So I have to install. I cannot push. I cannot use the push installation because the machine is not here. So whatever I am doing, I have to do it manually here only. So let's see how this client will install. First we'll check whether the client is already there or not. So no CCM folder, CCM cache, or the CCM SATA folder is here. I have copied the CCM client folder. So this SATA file, you can get it from your SCCM manager under the program files. So you can get, I will show you that also, how you will get the SATA file. So I am in the D drive, program file and configuration file. So if you install in the C drive, but you have to go to the Microsoft configuration manager, and this is the CCM setup folder here. So you can copy this. Oh sorry, client will be there. Okay, so this is the folder. So this complete folder you can copy. So all the prerequisite, whatever the clients needed, like a .NET or the redirectional or any other thing. So all the things will be inbuilt here only. No need to go with the any extra thing. And now let me go to the here in the my test machine. So what and all we needed to install the clients, I write a script. Because when I'm typing, always I did the mistake. So I create the script, and so it's very comfortable to work me. And but I can explain you, when you are giving the CCM setup path like this, and here is a CCM setup. So here is a CCM setup, and later on what is the no services. Why the no services? No services is like it will not take the local account. Okay, so if you are using the local account, again it will cause an issue. So we are using the no services. In that case, it will use the our SCCM client. So local client is not required, that's why we are using no services. Again it's the site code. So command line is a like SMS site code equal to BLR. Okay, then it is like a which port it will communicate. If you want to give the port name, you can give it, not at all necessary. CCM cache, if you want to bound it, like it should be like a 4GB 4000 MB that cache size will be there, or you want to bound it up to 10 GB, so you can bound it. FSP, this also is not required, but you can set up. FSP is a fallback status point. During the installation, if something goes wrong or right, everything it will update to SCCM. Okay, so fallback status point is required to check the logs in your SCCM console only. So that's why I given here for the troubleshooting. SMS MP. So this is the my MP. Where is the my MP? Where it will report. So if you want to use this, you can use, or if you want to give the command line, you can give the like a same command line, like a no services or like that, you can type it. So I don't want to type it. I fixed it in my script. Now let me run this script. Now run administrator and let it be. Now we'll see the logs. We'll go to the C drive, Windows, and here is a folder created SCCM setup. Let me check how it will install. So guys, you seen it here, there was no setup folder, and now first created a setup folder, then the CCM setup MSI or this SCP Windows firewall, and these all the things from where he got. He actually downloaded. When I run this script, it start downloading from that folder. Means is in the software, it's copied from this folder to CCM setup, and then it start installation. Now we'll see the logs, which logs we can check whether the client is installing or not. So this is my the CCM setup, so it's going on. Let it install completely. Okay, so it will not take much time, very fastly it will install. And the thing is, if there is any prerequisite missing, like you don't have the .NET 4.5.2 is required, so first it will install, and if there is any prerequisite missing, it will install. So here is a one error. Let's see, it's time to connect the NP, and it's got field, it looks like that responding the Win HTTP. You know the HTTP is trying, but we'll see it. See, okay, so my folder is here. I will tell you one thing, whatever the errors come, if the last exit code 0 comes, that means this client installed successfully. Maybe this is a false error, or at that time it come when it was checking, and later on this error got resolved. But if error got resolved later on, that means is it will not overwrite this logs, so we have to check. And this is a component. Where is the component? It's a FSP component. Okay, so might be this error trigger because of the FSP. It's trying to update the status message to FSP and it's unable to reach. So that's why it's throwing the error. So it's a component for the FSP. If the FSP is not reachable, no problem. It's nothing gonna happen. So your client will work fine. Now we'll go with the logs file, and here you can see as a few logs only. So let me close this logs, and we'll see the policy agent. Nothing is here. Okay, we'll go to control panel. As it's a new installation, it will take some time to configure it. Let me open to configuration manager. Here I can see my the assigned MP is the SSCM, self assigned, currently intranet, site code BLR, and the client version. And here is a, when the new client will install, only the two things will be there, machine policy, user policy. So let me run the machine policy. So immediately my client will try to reach to SSCM, and it will ask for the policy, it will request for the policy. And again, it's a scenario will come, like if this IP is the part of boundary, then only it will get the policy, or else it will fail. So now you can see in it, here is there so many logscape, and it start getting the policy. So when it getting the policy, it will start configuring the other components. If it is not getting the policy, or the other component will not be configured, like software inventory, hardware inventory, or the other inventories, you can say. Here we can check the logs file. So now earlier it was 5-6 logs, but now it is a 54 logs created here. And here we can check the client location. Log is there. Where is my client? Okay, so domain join client in the intranet, and where it is a, it's the AD forest is a once.com. And which is that assigned MP? It was assigned MP this SSCM-DP-1s, but again it rolled back to another MP. So these how you can check your the client installation. So here is a assigned site code. What the site code assigned? It's a PLR site code assigned to my this client. So this is the site location, and the other logs you can check it, like this is the WA handler related to patching, or the policy agent provider, whether this policy is coming or not. So it will check the all the policy reached or whatever the status you can see in the agent policy and the policy agent provider, policy agent and the policy agent provider. And here again, let me open this client, it should be changed. So now see, this look got changed, and here is a few more tabs came, and under the action, earlier there was two things, machine policy and the user policy. But now here is so many actions came, like application deployment evaluation, hardware inventory, machine policy, and the other thing. So let me run the machine policy and discovery data, software inventory. Why I am running? Because I can show you in the SCCM console the inventory is updated or not. So guys, now here is my client is installed successfully. And let me check in the console whether it's came or not. So let me refresh. Still it is not here. I have to refresh my console. Okay. So now the my client came, Windows 7 test. Earlier it was not there. When I am doing client installation manually, so it will automatically add it to my console. And this client, last time we saw, it was not showing green, but now it came. And the same wise, this also client will be green after some time, because it will take some time to configure or submitting the inventory. Inventories will first reach to SSCM, then it will update to the database, and then it is like a long process. So it will take just 5-10 minutes and it will show the green. Okay guys, so these are two scenarios completed, and let me move to the third scenario. When this scenario will work, like when your machine is in a work group, it's not part of the domain. Okay, so I was showing you the prerequisite for the work group. Host file should be there, that already we checked it. So my the other prerequisite are the match same firewall, these all should be the like post account will not come to the picture, network access account will not come to the picture, because this machine in the work group, FQDN, okay, obviously it should be like reachable, and like it should be resolved the FQDN name, port should be open, file printing and the WMS should be open. So these things part of the work group prerequisite. Okay, so let me go to the my machine. This is my machine in a work group. As I showed you earlier, like this my machine in a work group. And now how I can install here my client. So let's go to here, and I'm going to software.
Okay guys, so my setup file is here. And let me open this setup file, and here it's not required, let me delete it. And this thing I have customized, as I shows you, it's little different. Okay, so here I changed the port. Even if you don't want to give the port, it's not necessary. Okay, and this also not necessary, as I explained you. But here I added the one more thing, that called is a DNS suffix. Okay, in the in my another client installation property, this part was not there, but this should be there in your workgroup machine. When you are installing any client on a workgroup machine, this should be added as a command line. If it is not added, your client will not install, because how he will come to know where is my MP, and MP name is given. Sorry. Not SMS, MP, DNS suffix. So why DNS suffix is required here? Because this DNS suffix is your the DNS name, your AD name.
where is your AD, not the AD complete name, DNS suffix name. So like I have the my domain name is once.com. So if I define it, I am telling to my machine, you search this AD, go there, and from AD you can get the MP details. So from there it will get the MP details and it will install here. Okay, so site code it will get, sorry, MP and the site code, both it will get. So site code from where it will get only the to the AD, then it will go to the SCCM. Okay, so workgroup installation is a little different. When you start run this script, it will first it will reach out to the DNS suffix. From there it will search, okay, this site code is there or not, or the MP is there or not. If it is a published, from there it will get the site code and it will configure in that. Because when you are installing the client, it will not directly, it will not reach to your SCCM server. So let me run this script and see how it will work. Okay, this folder is created. As you know, first it will copy the setup file from that folder to here, and then it will start installation. Okay, so these are copied because setup is locally, so it will not take time. Now the installation also started. Let me see, let me go and show to you from where it is started. 1 minute structure. Okay, so from here it has started. Launch from the folder. From where it launched? It launched from the software, C drive software client. Client version is this, and it checked. This is the folder, is not found. Task does not exist, and now it's checking the Windows. I am using the Windows version Microsoft 7 Unlimited. And guys, would like to tell you, if you are having the Windows home version, client will not work. So first thing, and anyway, in your company, in first extra home version will not be there. But if you are testing at home, use the Unlimited and the other versions. So it client will install, or home version client will not support. And here is a command line what it used. CCM setup exe, source file is this, and here you can see the no services came, site code blr, and whatever we was given, it entire thing copy in his own format and it put it here. And here is the DNS suffix. So this is the command line we have given. And what it will do, the chipset port is this, HTTP port, HTTPS port is this, and the lookup MP, from where it will look up SCCM.once.com, FSP is this, and you can check this information here. And the MSI log will be in the client MSI folder. So here is a, again, MSI properties. So these are the my MSI properties. If you want to read it more, the logs file. Now it is started, and it's the progress where downloading the clients, and now we can see that last. Okay, it success very fastly without any error. So my the exit code is 0, that means is everything fine, and my client got installed successfully. Now I can go in the C drive Windows, and here is the folder CCM setup. Okay, that we checked. CCM cache is created to save the deployment packages here, as it's a empty because there is no deployment. And here is a folder, we can check the logs file here. Here is a few logs only came, and we can go to the control panel to run the policies. So other logs will come. Anyway, it started to coming here. I can go to the configuration manager, and here you can see in it my MP assigned is SMS MP, and the currently is intranet, site code is BLR. So it's gathered detail from AD. and this thing is a machine policy came, user policy came. Let me run the machine policy, user policy, so these are the policies. Now we'll go here and we can see the logs file is increased. So let me check the policy agent. Still nothing is there because it's not start getting the policies. And again, it's before getting the policies, it will check in the SCCM. It will reach the SCCM and it will check the whether the boundary is configured or not. If boundary is not configured, then SCCM will not give any policy to client. It will say no, you are not my the part. Okay, so now the logs file are increasing. So this logs file also will be updating. Why policy agent? Let me open it again. It will update after some time. And we can check the client location. Client, where it went. Client location. What is my the client location? It's an work group client in intranet. So my work group client is working under the intranet. So here you can check it. And what is the site code? Client is now successfully assigned the site code BLR and the MP is SCCM.once.com. So my client code MP and the site code, everything is fine here. And it's getting the other logs file also. So again, let me reopen this. So this part will change. Configuration manager. Okay, let me close this. Still it didn't get the complete policy. Need some more time. We'll run it. Let me refresh this. Go back. Okay, so still it didn't get, but it will get. So here you can see in the site code is BLR. If you click here, so you will get the DNS suffix also. And if you check the other client, which is the domain, DNS suffix is not required. Let me open again. Okay, it will come. We can wait some time. Or we can check the state messages if there is something goes wrong. State messages, if something goes wrong, it will update here. Here was one error, WPD deployment status is the messages stored, adding these. So here all the status messages will update and this status messages will send it to SCCM console. So centralized, we can check what is going on in my client. Incident status, what it's showing. It's working fine. We have to wait a little more. And let me check out in the SCCM console. Oh, it locked. Whether this client is there or not. Let me refresh. Okay, so my client added here and it's showing like a client is yes and it's showing site code is assigned BLR and the client activity is active. So it will active after some time, like these two client got active last time we did it this one. So it's now it's in green mode and it's showing this hardware scan, software scan policy also will come after some time. We can see in this. So this also hardware scan is didn't came, but it will update that. Okay, so the main thing is we have to check the client is yes, site code is assigned and the client activity is active and this status should be in a green mode. That means its client is communicating with your SCCM. So it still it is not come, but after some time it will come. Let me go to the again here. So it's taking some time because it's in a work group, So it will be little slow to finding the path and reaching the policy there. Okay, but it will install. As I showed you, the main important thing is the client installation. So, client installation exit code should be 0. And the CCM, where is the my CCM log? Sorry, that is on there. Policy agent is working fine. That means it's getting the policies. And just now it get the policy 350, 353. So it's collecting the policies and it will take a little time to update to back to the database and it will show green there. So everything fine. Here is no error. That means it's working fine. Okay guys, so this scenario also was completed. Let me go here and where is my part. So all the three scenarios are completed and these was the my prerequisite what we used. So thank you guys for watching this video. I hope so it's clear like how we can install the client. And it's a big lengthy video because if you want to understand deeply something, so it will be like a, obviously we have to give a more time. Okay guys, so thank you for watching this video. See you soon in my next video.